Hearing of a case against Kopriam Kasolo and others resumed today before Justice Isaac Mwata for the cross-examination of a 21st prosecution witness, Detective Sergeant James Barasa. During cross-examination, the prime suspect, Kopriam Kasolo, pinned Barasa of torturing him and forcing him to confess to murdering Najirinya and Kitaimbwa.
Nga tewali kukakibwa kwonna ng'era tewali kuntulugunya kwonna. Kituufu? Njagala obulire kkooti. Lwaki bwe mba nga nakkiriza ku poliisi nga tewali kuntulugunya nti omusango naguzza? Lwaki bwe naleetebwa mu kkooti eno era naye awatali kuntulugunya nga bw'ogamba nga bwe nali ku poliisi nga nzikiriza? Lwaki kkooti bwe yansomera omusango guno lwaki nagitegeeza nti omusango sigumanyi?
Defense lawyer Julius Serwambala also quizzed the witness about the whereabouts of some exhibits such as the panga, the log and the kajak that were reportedly used in killing Najirinya and her driver. Barasa informed court that some of these important pieces of evidence were destroyed in a fire that ravaged Katwe police station exhibit store some time back. After cross-examination, prosecution led by senior state attorney Jonathan Mwaganya informed court that this was their last witness and that they had closed their case. Court adjourned the matter to the 14th of April 2023 for the suspects to commence their defense. Five suspects, including Kopriam Kasolo, Johnson Lubega, Sharif Mpanga, Nasif Kalyango, and Hassan Kiseka, are facing six counts of murder, kidnap, and aggravated robbery offenses committed in 2019 at Lunguja, a Kampala suburb. The group reportedly kidnapped Najirinya and her driver before driving them to Nama in Mukono district, where they dumped their bodies. Their co-accused Isaac Senavulia earlier pleaded guilty to the charges and was sentenced to 40 years imprisonment. He was used as a state witness. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.